In this video, we'll show you how to set up the company absence calendar and assign the appropriate access rights to your employees. You need to set up the company absence calendar before creating employee roles, as you will later grant access to it for every role you define. When setting up the company absence calendar, you can set which absences are displayed in the Out Today widget on the dashboard, so employees can easily see their colleagues' absences. You can also set which absences display in the absence timeline, and set whether employees in general can see the type of absence when employees are out. You can do this based on role. Step 1. Set up the company absence calendar. To set up the company absence calendar, go to Settings, Work Hours and Absences, Company Calendar. Under Choose Absence Types, select the absence types you want the calendar to display by checking the boxes. This sets which absence types will display as generic grey absences in the company calendar, but it doesn't set if employees can see what type it is, as this is done later using access rights. So these absences show as a grey absence without showing the type, and then later, when setting up your roles, you can decide who can see what type they are. This allows you to maintain privacy. For example, you might want the whole company to know when someone is out, but you might not want everyone to know that they're on sick leave. The absence types you choose here will also show as out today on employees' dashboards, without showing the absence type. However, you may have some absence types, such as home office, where the employee is actually working. In this case, you would not want this to show as a generic absence in the company calendar, as people would think this person is not available at all. Step 2. Set up access rights. Once you've set which absences show in the company calendar in general, you can then set up access rights to determine which absence types certain roles can see. To do this, go to Settings, People, Employee Roles. Under Roles, select the relevant role, and then click the Calendars tab on the right. These calendar access rights apply to the calendar only, not to the absence tabs of individual employees, and they may override view permissions stored in the general access rights. So for example, if we allow a role to see sick days for all in the access rights tab, we could still hide sick days from the calendar in the calendar rights tab. You should set up the access rights for the role all employees first, as this group has the most implications for privacy. Under Company Calendar, Absences, you can define which of their colleagues' absences employees with the role can see as generic absences in their absence calendar. Then, in the Absence Types section, select which specific types of absence will be displayed for the selected group. For example, if you select Global, then this role can see generic grey absences for everyone in the company, as long as you've set those absences to show in the calendar in Settings Company Calendar. However, they won't see what type of absences they are unless you also do this for each absence type in Absence Types below. Of course, you can also set this visibility based on team, department, and office, etc. So for example, you could set absences to global so everyone can see when somebody is out, but only allow people in an employee's own team to see that they're on parental leave. Congratulations! You have set up your company absence calendar and configured what absences your employees can see.